Well, that's cool.
Am I getting fan noise from me? I might be getting fan noise from you. That's right, it's hot. Oh, wait, wait, shh, shh, shh. Here we go. Live from Houston, Texas, it's Ginger Snaps Wednesday with Ginger Cook at the helm, more or less. Let's see what's going on. Sammy, my man. Hey, I really appreciate you taking a day off from the pool and joining us in the house at the studio. Good man. Ginger.
Oh, Sammy's ready for vacation, John.
I am telling you, that boy is getting ready for cruising time.
He's ready for cruising, man. He's letting him do that. Well, welcome to our channel, you guys. This is Ginger Cook Live, and what we do on Wednesdays is and Tuesdays and Mondays is we create art, and we create acrylic art, and we show you how to do it. And sometimes on Mondays, we try to work on... Well, you have a hand up in the air, John, like something's happening. A finger, like you need the restroom. What's going on here?
Well, you were just saying, and we were just talking, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, let's break the news.
Well, we think that come April...
The end of April.
The end of April.
26th, I think, is the last Wednesday.
It will be the last Wednesday class we do, because John's Painting with John has become such a hit, and it's a lot of production time for us to do four shows, you know, three live shows a week, plus... you know, doing some of these RAS shows, and when we're teaching John to paint, that's not even like we're working, that's a kind of a different kind of deal. So we're gonna make sure that John is painting with us once a week, and we're gonna follow John's journey, who's never painted before, and so far we've done two classes with him, and you're gonna follow along and watch John become a master acrylic artist.
Woo-hoo.
So that's we're gonna do that, and that'll be you know, live, unedited, and you'll see the whole thing, okay?
Uncensored and everything.
Well, yes, uncensored too. Yes,
I'm afraid so,
very
yeah.
Good. So anyway, I think come the end of
April 26th will be our last Wednesday.
But right now, tonight, I'm excited to tell you, I'm going to hold this up. Tonight we are going to be painting this darling little dog, okay? I'm going to show you how to do that. I'm going to show you an interesting way to do it. I think when you see the photograph, a lot of people would be intimidated by this. They go, oh man, that's so cute, I don't think I could do it. I'm going to just kind of break it down. You know, it's like math. If somebody says, what is 2 into 2,222,000?
I get a calculator.
I mean, you don't do it like that. You go 2 into 2 is 1, and you know how you break down the math problem. This is what you've got to do with painting. You've got to break it down. And just the way you do math, you break down art, all right? And you simplify it, and then you unravel the puzzle in your mind, okay? That's basically what it is unraveling the puzzle. And that's what we're going to do tonight with this dog. So, John, and also I want to welcome everybody. We've got to thank our moderators who are online with us on board today. I think we've got Wendy and Kim Sung, and do we have anyone else?
Sandra.
Huh?
Sandra.
Sandra?
Which goes under Madonna.
Medina.
Now, this came up. We had an email come in. Medina has started up a Facebook group getting painting buddies. And she wanted, you know, the person that wrote us wanted to make sure that we knew this was going on. And yes, we do know this is going on. And we have giving blessings to do this.
And let me just say, while we're waiting for a few people to catch up with us, we could be doing an underpainting while we're doing this. So let's focus down here to the paint. I'll be putting paint out. I'm going to give you the skinny on why I'm thinking that this painting buddy thing is such a good idea.
Okay, skinny.
So as an artist, two things can happen in your family, maybe three. Three things can happen. You start painting, and the first time you do something, everybody's being real nice. Oh, that's so nice. And then after a while, the peanut gallery over there thinks that, well, that's nice, but I think you should do this. And you know, sometimes you don't think these people are qualified to make judgments on your artwork. Doesn't feel very nice. Maybe they're just trying to be helpful, but it doesn't feel helpful. You know what I'm saying? And so then you throw it out there, and then the other thing they could do is they could just, you know, they're saying, oh, it's lovely, and they're smiling, and you think they're lying through their teeth because you think something wrong with it, so you kind of want to know, but you're not sure you want them to tell you. And then the third thing that can happen kind of is, oh, that's so nice. I tell you what, I've got this photo from our trip in Paris last year. I think it would be great if you did this and put my cousin Susie in there and add the boat. And you're sitting there thinking that, you know, you don't even have the qualifications to do the boat yet, and they've thrown this project on you, and now you're stuck doing some sort of horrible picture, and you're taking the joy right out of Mudville for you, Pinkville. The joy has left, okay? So the idea behind the painting buddies is, and then the other thing sometimes people do is, well, they'll take the painting and they'll not quite finish, they'll throw it up on Facebook, and then everybody, you know, no one wants to be rude on Facebook, so what's everybody going to say? Oh, that's nice, you know? And you're thinking, yeah, but something wrong. You might get a few suggestions, but You know, then you don't want to overwhelm people and seem needy. So the idea behind a painting buddy is to find another artist on Facebook, somebody in another country, get a paint like a pen pal. And, you know, this is strictly voluntary. It's an idea I had because I've watched it work with some other artists. And you kind of, that's the person you encourage. Are you painting today? It's like your gym buddy. I'm going to the gym. I'm painting today. What'd you paint? Oh, that's nice. I think you could do this. It's just one person. It's kind of, they're your person. And I just thought it was a nice thing. I talked to my daughter, Cinnamon. She thinks it's a nice thing, too. Just something to kind of encourage you to keep painting, okay? And then you don't wear out the relatives or get unwanted. You don't get unwanted opinions or have to promise to babysit if they give you another opinion, that kind of stuff, you know?
I see you put a lot of paint out.
I'm putting paint out because I have to think about these things. This is a thing, right? So, all right, I'm going to put out two colors for now. I'm going to put out a burnt umber and dazzling purple. And the reason for that is that that's all the colors I'm going to put out and why this stuff's drying. I'm going to do an underpainting for the dog. And we want a real dark underpainting, and we're going to let it dry, okay? And then we'll tell you some more stuff.
Well, I'll tell you some stuff while she's kind of doing this. Medina's got her Facebook link right there. This is going to be a temporary. I'm hoping she won't keep it over there. We want to bring it over to our form once we get the form finished up. So it'll be because a lot of people do not use Facebook. Everybody can use our website. The only requirement for the form is you just have to create an account. If you go under the Join Us right now, you can create your form account. We'll have a link out there shortly to get to the form. And we'll be finishing that up so we can start moving in that direction. Also, somebody asked when the painting with John Lessons will be. They are considered a RAS, which means it's a reality art studio, and they're going to be potluck. But primarily, we're going to target Sundays, Sunday afternoon. But that does depend on my schedule with Ginger shooting. I have to edit. I'm getting way behind on editing because she keeps shooting and shooting and editing don't coincide. Her shooting is like 7 hours and my editing is like 50 hours to do her 7 hours. So we're falling a little bit behind. That is one reason we have to give up one of these live, and we felt that most people would not mind doing that, giving up on Wednesday. So we're targeting for Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday, but the Sunday could rotate. We will post it on our calendar, again on our form, and if you belong to our form, you'll get an email whenever I put something on the form.
Well, 6 weeks away. I mean,
you got plenty of time. Don't go in panic mode, people.
We're
kind of weaning you off.
We're just letting people know that we thought this is what we thought we'd do. Now, you'll notice that in this period of time, I've used a Ruby Satin Silver number 12 bright brush, and you notice how beautifully and quickly it covered this canvas, all right? And you can see that it's wet. Right?
It's all glistening.
If I chip it. So what I'm going to do now is put the hair dryer on this, all right? And again, I want to welcome everybody to our channel. If you've just popped in to see what we're doing, we're going to be painting this cute little dog. And while I'm drawing it, John probably has some public service announcements. And listen, if you guys, I'm going to say this again, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, we appreciate it if you would do so. And also, if you like this video, share it. Listen, that's a nice thing you can do for us. Share it. All right, thanks. And I'm going to start drawing, and John's going to kind of tune out the sound a little bit, all right?
The best I can. We have turned her down. John, at least give us a few hours' notice before the rest. I will post it as soon as Ginger and I decide when and what time. I did it last time we did one, and it was about an hour prior. I mean, so many times, we just all of a sudden grab our paintbrush and go for it. We will try to get better on that. Public service announcement. I want people to remember we still have the auction going on. It's been going fast and furious. These are original Ginger Cook paintings from our lessons that we're auctioning off. This is the first round. The first round has been very exciting. A lot of activity on it. We're going to try to update the prices as they go along as quickly as we can. The next time we're looking at some software to run it more like an eBay auction, so it'll be a little bit easier for everybody and won't consume my time. Yes, it would be nice for John to schedule it, but again, if I don't have the time because I'm editing or working on another project, I can't, you know, I don't want to put it out there and then disappoint you and not show up. Where do you find the form? Wendy, could you put a link out there? Because I don't have the menu out on the top level as of yet. Wendy will do that, and I hope. Maybe by the weekend I'll have a link. It'll be up in the menu. I know you hear the blower. I don't have a way to shut her off completely. We are in the same room.
All right. So I've dried the canvas. All right. Now let me show you the genesis for this picture. I like that word. Don't you like that word? And that's not our secret word, by the way.
We don't have
the painting to show for the secret word, John. You need to grab that for us. Okay. So I was going over to paint my photo today. And they have like 7,000 photos on there. I'm telling you what, to find an interesting photo, it takes some hunting. This just doesn't happen. But I found this photo of the dog. Isn't that cute? And then I went ahead and I cropped it so it would be, I just didn't think all that was all that interesting. So I cropped it like this, kind of got a close-up of this, and I cropped it, okay? So then I went ahead and then I printed out a black and white picture of it, because that's one of the things you can do, so I could really see the values. And what you see is here, these eyes are so dark and, you know, mysterious. You're seeing the dog and you've got the little basket. So if you look at our painting here, now I'm going to put the painting right kind of like that, see? So I'm going to show, but this was basically how we did it. Then I went ahead and we printed out, instead of on shiny paper, we printed out the dog again, just on regular paper. And there's a couple of ways. You can grid it on, kind of the way, if you've seen our cat video on YouTube, man, it's so old. It's like the first camera we ever had. Such a bad video, but it's got like 13,000 views. I had to take it down. But, you know, we have to remake that cat video. But if you've seen that, that's kind of show you how to grid something if you don't know how. But one thing you can do is just sort of divide your canvas up and your image up into four, so you kind of understand where the eye placement is, all right? But then I thought, well, the other thing to do is to just go ahead, you can see where I trimmed it a little tiny bit to fit my 8x10 canvas. The other thing you can do is just go over to Paint My Photo, go to Ginger Cook, and find my gallery. And you'll see, I will post this picture up in my gallery tonight. I haven't done it yet, but I'll post up my gallery tonight. And the rules are, when you're a member of Paint My Photo, you can post a painting up from one of those photos, but you have to put a link to the actual photograph. So that will give you the link to the actual photograph, and you're more than welcome to then, you know, download it and print it out, okay? And I'm going to just, you know, make this great suggestion that that we go ahead and just, for tonight, we're just going to trace it on. That's pretty easy. We're using some transfer paper. I'm going to...
coffee cup. Oh, sorry.
This transferred paper can be used over and over again. That's the nice thing about it. It comes either in sheets like this. It's by Sorel. And you can use it over and over again. I'm just taping a little of this down so that it doesn't move, okay, like this. Like that. I just don't want my transfer paper to move. And I'm going to test it to make sure I have it up on the correct side.
It's really hard to tell on that stuff, too.
Well, it is hard to tell. And it, one side's more, you know, kind of shinier than the other. Let's see, where did the pen go?
Do, 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 do.
I tell you what, I laid this all out.
I had nothing to do with the pin, boss. Nope. Isn't that right there next to you?
Is it? Yes, it's right here. See?
I can see it from over on the other side of the room.
Bank. Okay, gosh, isn't that great? You know, just because you have eye surgery doesn't mean that they got the translation bit, you know, up here. Okay, so it does work. You see how you can see on the other side? So now that I've got that, you just test it. Make sure you got the right side facing you. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to square up my picture like this. And I will tape that down, too, using artist tape. This came up the other day. Someone said they were using tape, and it pulled all the paint off. No kidding. Of course it will. You want something that's called artist tape. There's a reason they call it that. In fact, Scotch is now making stuff on artist tape for watercolor paper. I've seen that in the art store. I'm not a watercolor artist, but I have done watercolor in the past. But, you know, if I was doing watercolor, that's what I'd have. And let me just share. I've got this straightened up so it's not...
We will discuss the secret word stuff in a little bit.
I don't think I got this up high enough, John. Let me just redo this. Okay, so I want to come up just about like this. There we go. Let me just move. Oh, here. This got to level up the bottom of this. Wow, how this can't be that hard. Gonna level up the bottom of that. So the bottom is what I really want to get level here. Here's the bottom of this, right like here. Let me move this up right like there, like that, okay? Like this, like that. Okay, the reason you have to tape it, because it goes all wrong if this moves, all right? So you need to tape it down so that it doesn't, your stuff doesn't go anywhere. Your picture doesn't slide around. And, you know, we're only going to do a couple of eyes here, but if you were doing a very elaborate picture, you darn well care if it started moving. All right. So now I'm going to take a pen, put my glasses on, and I'm just going to come up here like this and say where I've got the doggy. Okay, like this. I've got some stuff coming out this way.
I believe that stuff's called
hairs. And then I'm going to do the inside of the eyes like this, and like that. I'm going to go down, and I'm going to double check. See it? Oh, it did it. It's got it. I'm going to come over here and do these eyes. Okay. And then I want to kind of do this area here that's going to come underneath this eye like that. Now the nose is very important. I want to make sure I have the nose down correctly. Okay. Here's our nose. It's going to come down like this, almost to a point like that. And there's another little deal here. That and here. Now, the problem is I used this pen before, so I have to talk out loud to what we're doing or I will lose sort of the focus on where everything is. Does that make sense?
What's the name of that transfer paper again?
Sorel, S-E-R-A-L.
We'll find it and show it in a moment.
And yeah, we'll show it because the reason I like this is all they make it in like a wax paper roll, but you've got yards of it. This stuff just lasts you a lifetime. What are you going to do with yards of this? And then you only have one color, where if you buy the variety pack, they give you four colors. They give you red,
blue,
white, and kind of a charcoal and a yellow. So really between, you need some, let me just move this up here. You need some that are, you know, darker if you're going, if you're going over a light background, maybe a yellow background, you'd want a blue, maybe. Or a dark color. I think I put it over there. Did you find it?
It's right next to you on the left of you.
Okay, so I'm just going to do this. And I mean, I don't know that I would have to transfer it to color. You know, I think I could probably freehand in this basket. But I'm just doing that now anyway because I think that will help you just to sort of see how we do it, right? Like that. What's going on up here? Okay.
The picture came from Paint My Photo.
Paint My Photo is where the photograph came from.
Ginger,
but you could use the
up.
Photograph of anybody's dog. I mean, you know, it's just where it came from. This is kind of how, if you had a dog like this, this is how you're going to, you know, put it on here like this. And we're coming out about like this. Okay. All right.
We have a question from Deborah. Why do some people use an easel and others don't?
Well, we're not using an easel because normally I would use an easel. But we're doing an easel because this is just easier for me to show you how to paint this way, okay?
It's
easier for me and we're doing something small. If I'm doing a big picture, that's right. I have a $5,000 easel behind me, electric easel, and that's what we do it on, okay?
Yeah.
So, but these little small paintings, it's easier for me to do it like this, okay? Now, let's see, am I good here? Let me see if I'm going to make sure I'm good here.
Normally, you would use a different colored pen, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I would use a different colored pen. If I used one colored pen, I would use a red pen or something like that, right? But I think we're okay. There, see?
Perfect.
Perfect. I mean, I just needed to know where the eyes, the nose, and this stuff went, right? So, somehow, we're going to take that, and let's just move all this out of the way. Like, oh, come on. There. Here, I'm throwing that out. There.
I hope you don't
me.
Want to do it just, again.
No, that's it. The last time we're doing it this size. All right, so here we're going to go from, just so you'll know, we're going to, gosh, now we're putting, oh, we didn't get any paint out. That's why we didn't put paint out. There's a reason. We're going to take this picture, which is not the one. Where's the one? Now, this one we've made smaller, right? We've cropped it. So this is the one we're doing. This painting's picture is going to, whoo, throwing and flinging, right? We're in a flinging mood today. So there's our black and white version, all right? Right, you can see that there's our black and white version, and it's very. And so here's our painting. This is what we're painting. All right. So we got to get from this to this. Now this already throws people off. They're going, I don't know. This doesn't look like that. How do you get from there to there? Well, we're going to show you how to do that. And I'm going to put some paint back and talk to you about it. So one of the things that's really important to do is to always, in acrylics, you don't do this with watercolor. Acrylics, you start with your darkest color first, your farthest thing away. The farthest thing away is a light color. Okay, so if you're doing a sunset, maybe your farthest thing away is yellow, so it's not as dark as brown. But you start, and something like this with a portrait, we're starting with the dark colors, and we're going to bring ourselves forward. Now, I want this beautiful blue in the nose, and we're not using any black in this picture. Here's some ultramarine blue, which I have to, squeeze out a little bit, and we want some phthalo blue. We have purple, and we have white, and we're going to have cadmium aluminum. Pretty much the same gang of characters we use in every painting, all right? Just use the same things all the time. Well, if you just put out a list, it's the same thing. It's real dull, same stuff. I rarely surprise you with new colors. It's a very rare thing. Now, I lied having said that, and because I do have a color that we are going to use, I'm going to get out. It's a color we don't use all that often. You can either use Golden Azo Gold, or you can use Australian Sienna, which is this one. You can use either one of those, all right? I don't know where I'm going to put it. Probably, I'll put it between these two up here like that, okay? Australian Sienna, and the reason I like it, it's a transparent color, all right? And I'm going to put that there so you can see it. And if you don't have it, burnt sienna will work. And also, Liquitex makes something called a transparent burnt sienna, which is not a terrible color either. So here's cadmium medium, all right? And we want yellow oxide, which is our yellow ochre, which is your gold color. Now, there we go. And let's see. Oh, I did put Australian sienna. I made a spot for it there. Well, it just shows you I don't read well, doesn't it? Huh. Okay, here's our zinc white.
Have her move down. I can't see the drawing. What? I can see the drawing.
What do you mean you can't see the drawing?
I don't know.
There's the drawing right here.
Yeah, the drawing's there.
There's the drawing.
I don't have the little guy in the top showing all the way yet. Okay. We have a question in regards to...
Yeah, we'll put out Cad Red while we're doing that. Yeah.
Beverly would like to know, what makes an artist rather than someone who just paints as a hobby?
Oh, I think you could be an artist and be a hobby artist. The idea that, that you turn it into a business and sell things, there's the hobby gardener, hobbyist gardener, who just enjoys, maybe grafting roses and going to shows and, but not trying to, start a nursery, just enjoys the hobby. There's nothing wrong. It's a great hobby. There's nothing wrong. It doesn't make you not an artist. Generally professional artists are people that have got publishers and just like authors, there's a difference between, submitting a magazine article, a little short story to a magazine and just having them publish it, which is a neat thing, and another thing to be paid as an author. So I guess a lot of it's skill level, but sometimes it's just preference. You can ruin a hobby fast by turning it into a business. A lot of people, once you turn it into a business, it's not fun anymore. This
it
happens
a
to
job.
Be a cad red light. That's kind of another exception to the colors we're doing. And I want burnt sienna. Those are my two sort of surprise colors on this, all right?
Oh, we'd love surprise colors.
I mean, I just would have to tell you that's, they have said, and I'm telling you what, I don't have the studies for it, but I have read that there's only two things they think reverse aging in the brain. And one is composing music, which I think would be sort of tough to do if you'd never done it your whole life. And the other is painting. And you can take a painting at any age, you don't have to be good at it. Just the focusing on the painting apparently does great things for your brain. So, if you've got some older parents, get them a little watercolor set and a brush in the morning and tell them to doodle when they're having coffee. If you want to engage them in art lessons and get out there to the community and meet other people and get on YouTube and follow some, YouTube people that are doing stuff, it can be a fun thing to do, all right? But it's all right to have it a hobby. Okay, so you guys are kind of with me so far, right? I'm going to just finish this drawing that I didn't quite get here. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is put in the eyes. That's the first thing I want to do is put these eyes in, all right? So I'm going to mix some ultramarine blue and a little purple. And I'm going to put my glasses on so I can see. And I want my reference photo, which I don't think I flung across the room. I'm pretty sure I didn't. And I want to go ahead, even though I have this, I'm going to go ahead and go off my reference photo, all right? And I want to come like this and just, I'm taking this blue and purple and painting over this eye like that. And I'm going to do the same thing over here. Now this eye on this side is open a little bit more. It almost looks a little bigger, and it kind of is. It's slightly bigger in this photograph than this one, and that's just the nature of the photograph. So we might compensate for that a little bit. Sometimes a photograph can be a little misleading. We're going to kind of balance that eye out just a hair. Now, what I might do is just take a little bit of white on my brush. This is a little 3/8 inch ruby satin silver
angle brush
like yep. this. I'm going to come under here like this and do that. And just come over the top of the lid like that. And let's see, let's do this again. And come under here like this. Okay. Now put a little bit of burnt sienna with that. And come on the top of the lid right here like that. Okay, and let's bring this up here. Okay, so that's, I've got my eyes, and not so much. You know what I'm missing, John, is the little heart thing that has my water in it.
Of course you are.
I only mention that because he set it up, you know, because I'm not complaining. I wouldn't want you to think I was complaining.
Oh,
hey,
no,
we've got a great game to play with you today while we're painting this in. You know, we're doing this thing where we have the secret word, and we're going to tell you about that. So I'm painting in the nose, same colors, the purple and the ultramarine blue, okay? And I'm going to come in on the inside of this. That's a little too blue. Let's put a little purpler in it, make it almost black. There you go, too much paint.
This already has
excellent. I'm going to just, one thing I forgot to do was put this little brush out on the side here. So I want to, this paper towel. I like to have a piece of paper towel right next to what I'm painting because you don't want a big glob. See this big glob of paint on my brush? You don't want that. You got to knock it off. Here, now, coming up here like this, I'm going to come under here and paint in the nose, and then I'm going to take a little white and I'm going to paint the top of this nose. That's a little bit, let's take a little phthalo blue with that. Little white, and so the top of the nose here is phthalo blue. Then I'm going to come around like a dyslexic letter C, and come under here with that, and then a little bit of burnt umber and purple, and finish this side of the nose. The left side of the nose is a darker, okay, like that. So the only way this will show up is if we put some light with next to it. All right, so there's the old rule here. Wherever there's a light, there's a dark. Okay, like that. Okay, and I'm just gonna lighten this up a bit here too. Now we can come back and make some adjustments, but right now I just wanted to generally get our nose in. All right, and here's our
just
eye.
Just get our nose in.
Just to get our nose in and get our eyes in. So anyway, we've got this contest going on. All right, and I'm going to do this with a little bit of the phthalo blue now in white. Go over this eye. And it's a neat contest in that we're going to give away a painting. The one from The Promise. Everybody seems to like that painting. I'm going to go ahead and give that away. And how you're going to win that is it's going to be in a random drawing. You're going to submit to us eight of probably...
At least 10 words.
At least 10 or more secret words that we're going to give you a couple secret words every video.
Yeah.
Every one of these live videos, we're going to give you a couple. Not on the Brads, but on every live video, we're going to give you a couple. And as long as you have eight, come the time that we'll let you know when it's time to email them to us. And then if you have at least eight, you're in the contest. And then we're going to do a drawing for for this painting right here. And somebody, no matter where you were, if you live in England or Russia or wherever you live, I will mail it to you. And this is an original painting by me, so, you know, signed, personalized to you. This is The Promise. That was the video we put up a couple weeks ago on YouTube, okay? So that's how you win that painting. It's kind of a nice deal. Now, what we're asking you guys to do, we said this last night, we're going to say it again. This is, you don't want to tell someone the end of a book before they've read it. So if you know the secret word, or you hear it tonight, and it'll be a word that has nothing to do with anything, all right? It'll be totally outside the conversation we're having. So if you hear one of the secret words, don't shout it out to everybody. I know the secret word and tell everybody because that spoils the game for them.
And besides, that's going to be more people competition for you.
Yeah, and it's more people competition for you. And you know, we'd love to send you the thing. But if you want to private message one of your friends and say, hey, listen, here's the secret words. You couldn't do it. Listen, I don't care who you tell. Just don't spoil it for the people that want to play, okay?
Yeah, let's have fun with it.
Let's just have fun. But just try, we're just trying
and
to have
you know,
fun.
Now, there's no place on the website to send me yet. We're going to have a special place to go to. Don't send in one word at a time.
Yeah.
All eight have to be coming in at one time, and we will have a special link for that once we get to the end of the contest.
Yeah, okay. Now, we're going to put a little bit of a light blue and a turquoise blue and light little dot right here. Right there on this one. Come over here and do one here. A little bit there. Okay, so we started to put in the eyes. We're going to lighten up the top of this nose right here. See what we're doing? That's had a little chance to dry.
Ginger, you want to give a little shout out for our granddaughter Jail of Jaylee? Of Sherry's. Sherry's granddaughter is watching and said hi to Miss Ginger.
Oh, what's her name?
J-A-L-E-I.
Jelly?
Jelly?
Jelly? Hi.
Jelly.
Hi, okay. Good shout out to you. That's cool. Yeah, we'd absolutely do that. Yeah, that's fun. So anyway, you can see kind of what we're doing now. We've done the eye, you know, we've kind of done the eyes. Now I'm going to take a little bit of the burnt sienna and a little white, okay? And I've got my picture here. I'm just going to come above here like this with a little burnt sienna and white. And well, let's see, maybe a little tiny bit of cad red medium. Or rather, red light. I want to put a little bit of red right there, just over that dark brown here, a little bit in the corner here, a little bit of red. Now, I want to put a little bit of this orange color right under here and right back this way. Okay, so what we're doing is put a little bit of color. Now, we're going to start layering it on, okay? So, we're starting to layer on a little color. Now, what do we know? We know that it's pretty dark up this way, but if I come about above here like this, with kind of a little layer of lighter orange, and then come in with some dark brown, which would be ultramarine blue and burnt umber, I can come above here like this and do a little dark brown up into this, right up like that. And I want some dark brown right under here, around this eye, I want some dark brown. And I know it's going to be kind of hard to see that, so we'll do that in a minute. Now, okay, so what can we do? Oh yeah, let's put this in. Let's just take some yellow oxide. And
so somebody
bit of white.
Asked a question. I'm sorry. Somebody asked a question on yellow oxide. Is that considered a warm or a cool color?
It's yellow. It's a warm color.
They want to hear it from the professional.
Okay. So yellow. I think I'll put a little bit of Australian sienna with
warm.
It. Now look. Remember, yellow only paints well over white. So we didn't paint these white. So they're going to be toned down just a little because of that. Kind of using the angle of the brush to get these in here like this. Put a little white with them. Little titanium, and okay, let's see, I've got one kind of coming over this way, and we've got one kind of coming under this way.
So you kind of drew in all the little weaving, didn't
you?
Yeah,
I kind of drew them all in here, just kind of, I drew them in, but you know, sometimes when you're looking at this stuff, you're going, what was this, and what was this, and what was that, that kind of thing. And I think I've got a nice big one coming this way. We're just, it looks like he's, to me, like he was chewing the basket. That's my own personal opinion. See, looks like the basket got a little eaten there.
Well, the look on his face, you know.
You know, he looks a little, mischievous to me, right? But what do I know, right?
Hey, Susan would like to know, is the matte medium and gel medium the same?
No. No. It's not the same. Sorry, it's not the same. Gel medium is a thick, goopy stuff. And matte medium is a type of varnish. Not the same at all. Not the same stuff. One can pour, one's real thick, like jelly. Like jello or something. Thick. Soft, creamy. Alright, so that can be drying. So alright, let's work on the dog now while we're doing this. Alright? So
now that you're talking about the dog, a question from Chris is, what would you do if your dog has...
I have that orange here, and I want to come out from underneath here like this and start putting some fur. Want to come up like this with some orange color and out from the dog. All right, so we want to start putting in layers of kind of thick color. That's what we're doing now. This is just a kind of a cad red light and a little bit of cad yellow medium. Okay, kind of coming in this way. All right, so here's an example. Here's a cat with white fur. All right. But, you know, but you, but I, we, and again, we have a video on how to do this kitty on our website. There's over, you know, we have like 275 lessons on our website. And the reason we have so many is not everybody wants to paint the same thing. So we've got all kinds of stuff on there like that. And now we're going to come around the nose like this with this color. And start, remember, wherever there's a light, there's a dark. So if you want something to show up, you've got to have either a light or dark next to it. Okay, so that's kind of like a rule. So we're going to start saying that there's some fur going out this way. We know we've got some of this coming this way out from the eyes, like this. And the same thing here. We're going to come color to them. Okay, just as long as we're doing it. Okay, and then let's see. Let's take a little bit of white. Let me sure don't get that into paint, okay?
No,
take
yellow,
a little white and dazzling purple.
Going back to the yellow oxide, is that the same as yellow orchid, right?
Yes, uh-huh, yeah.
Okay, according to Grumbacher's color chart, color temperature list is considered a warm yellow color.
Okay.
Apparently they've been told it was cool somewhere along the line. It is not.
Oh, you know, it's just...
just because you heard it on the internet doesn't make it
make
true.
It true. Just, you know what
hey,
I mean?
Look at that. We're already having a feed problem. Isn't that great?
Are we? Well, listen, if you want to know why we're having a feed problem, because I always like to know these things, why are we having a feed problem? We're
yeah, why are we having a feed problem?
We're
you
having
know,
a feed
I wanna
problem,
know.
Apparently, dear friends, because YouTube is upgrading.
Oh, don't you love it when they upgrade?
They're upgrading. You know, the thing, can I mention something that bugs me about upgrades just in general? I feel
are you on your soapbox?
Yeah, this okay. is my soap. I feel very computer challenged sometimes. And I feel like
really?
Just when I figure out, yes, really, really. And just when I feel like I really understand the phone, they come out with a new model. It doesn't work like the other one at all. You know, or the programming. What was wrong with System 6? It was fine. Now we have to have 12. I was really doing good with the other one, and then you changed everything. And I don't, quite frankly, I'm a busy person. You must be too. I do not have hours of time to read new instructions. I want the washing machine to work like it did last year. You know what I mean? I don't mind a couple of new buttons, but, you know, I had the choice when I bought my new dryer. It had like 55 different settings or like 12. I'm going, how many ways can you dry something really? Let's go for the 12, right? It was only like $10 more to get the 55, and I'm thinking, no.
It's too confused. Well, think of the confusion, your headache.
It's just
indecisions.
It's just then decisions. Years ago, I had a friend, and really one of my closest friends, and she was a sewer. And I was lucky enough, we're just doing the same color and over again here. See, this was set layer two because it's drying, all right? I'm going to put some of these colors underneath like that, coming up here like this. Don't you love this? This is fun. Already starting to look like a dog. Aren't you impressed? Here. And anyway, so my good friend, Joan Bartlett.
Oh, throwing out names.
Well, she's passed away, I think, since then, you know.
You think? Terrible. My good friend. I think she's passed away. How good of a friend are you? Apparently,
well,
real close.
At the time, we were, you know, I was like 23 and she was like 35 and we were close friends. And then, you know, I moved and she moved. And there wasn't Facebook or internet to keep up with things, and I don't know what happened to her. But
okay.
Anyway, at the time, we were good friends. She was like my good friend at the time. Everybody's got a few of those at the time good friends, don't you? So
yeah,
anyway,
absolutely.
You know, I was at, had gone on this 6-week trip to Asia and Malaysia. This is before Cinnamon was born. And I wanted to bring her back a present, you know, because she was my good friend, you know. So she got it. So I wanted to give her a gifty. So the thing is, and I knew she sewed. So I ended up in Singapore, and I ended up going, some orange here, you see how I'm painting this? I ended up going to this warehouse fabric store, and it had bolts like this, floor to ceiling, that looked like it stretched the size of a Home Depot, of thousands of yards of silk fabric and every color possible. Now, if they'd given me like 10 choices, I could have picked something out for her. But then I'm thinking, gosh, she's a brunette, I'm a blonde, what does she wear? I don't know. The decision was overwhelming. I didn't buy any of it. I mean, I
How
could have
sad.
Come back with why. I know, because I was overwhelmed. I think it's easy to get overwhelmed with things. If people don't realize that you get too many choices, you get overwhelmed. We're not trying to overwhelm you on our website with too many choices, but we do know that there's a lot of nifty things to paint, okay?
Nifty things.
Nifty things to paint. And they're all, some of these lessons are really nice and long, and they're all step-by-step instructions that come with art, personal art coaching, which is a cool thing. Now, see, just still working in the oranges, see that? Now, while those are drying, okay, now look at, here's what we're going for here, okay? So what we're going for was our photograph. Oh, here's what the Sorrel paper looked like. Here's the Sorrel, S-A-R-A-L, transfer sample packet. It's wax-free, and you get like five colors. And what did we pay for this on Amazon? Not much, right?
Under 10.
Well, under 10 bucks. And you can use it over and over again. This was for most of the things we're doing. And if you needed a bigger piece, I think you could probably tape the white and the yellow together or something, you know?
If you're going to
do something big, it comes in a roll too, like wax paper. Comes in a big roll, but gosh, that's yards of that. And I'm sorry, I just think it's too much. Okay, so we're going to take a little bit of white in our orange now that we made and come over the top of this like this. Let's put a little bit of yellow with that, a little yellow oxide, like this sort of gold color. And everything gets layered. Do you understand? Everything is layered. So now we're layering in our basket weave, okay, like that. I'm going to layer this in here like this. Okay, and just doing like that and layering it here. And let's see, is something going over here? I think so. Here, let's just layer something kind of under here like that. All right, so there's our basket weave, and we've got this one. Oh, it's going to put a little white in. There we go, a little bit of white, a little bit of purple. There we go, kind of an off color here, kind of a beige color. And we're going to say that there's our little out piece. This is our piece that's out. Like that, there's some outy pieces, and I think I included, wasn't in the picture, but I thought for ease of understanding this, I put another one here. These little basket weave pieces, and we're going to run those off the canvas.
Here's a question from Brenda.
Uh-huh.
What is the difference between light and medium when it comes to the reds and the yellows?
What is the difference between what?
What's the difference between light and medium when it comes to the reds and the yellow? You have the light yellow and the medium.
Oh, that's a wonderful question. Yeah, that's a good question. Now, medium doesn't mean anything. Just ignore that word. So you've got something called cad red light, and you have cad red medium. Cad red medium is your orange color. You have cad yellow medium, which is your primary yellow. And it's actually, it's cadmium, C-A-D-I-U-M, cadmium, all right? And so you have cadmium red. Now, when they have cadmium red light, it's a lighter color. You cannot mix yellow with cad red medium and get this color. There are certain colors that cannot be mixed. They just can't be mixed, all right? So, you know, what colors can't you mix? You can't make Dasnine purple. All right, you can't make your primary colors. You really can't get these bright colors. If you want a bright kind of magenta color, you really have to buy it, all right?
And those are different than the hues, right?
Hues are artificially made colors.
So they wouldn't be as bright?
Sometimes they're brighter. Sometimes a hue is really brighter. They're artificially made. In other words, If you want to really understand about paints and stuff like that and get a great history, get the book by Victoria Finley called The History of the Color Palette.
That sounds like a good one.
And it's an awesome book, and it really explains down through time where we've found all these colors. You know, at one point, we used to take, to get a yellow, they used to take cow's urine in India. That's where the Indian yellow comes from, right?
Oh, that's nice to know.
And they would not give the cows any water, and they'd feed them certain plants, and so their urine got really, they'd have to dehydrate these cows, and their urine got really, really yellow. And then they would extract the paint from that. And then I think around 1910, the Indian government said that was inhumane to animals and not
especially
to do that.
Especially cows, isn't that their sacred animal?
Yeah, it is. But maybe it's not everybody's. Who knows who was doing it? You know how these things go, right?
Yeah.
But anyway,
true.
It was a business, so then everybody's going. So anyway, that's where. And then the other place that yellow used to come from was saffron.
Oh, yeah.
And
now, that's
saffron is, if you've ever used it in painting, all right, and cooking, saffron is this yellow spice that you put in paella in Eastern cooking, tiny bit of it. But you know, it's so expensive that a few ounces of that is worth more than gold, more than heroin. Yes, it's the most expensive stuff. And people say, well, what is it? You know, and she explains what all this stuff is. And saffron is the, let's see if anybody knows what it is. I'll throw that out to you. Anybody know what it is before I tell you?
Oh, you know what it is. I can Google it.
So if anybody wants to shout that out, I don't mind telling you. Now I'm going to start putting a shadow on one side of these little sticks here to make them look rounder. See how we're changing them a little bit here? It's like waiting for all that to dry.
So hey, anyway, what about throwing that dice while you're waiting for things to dry?
Yeah, let's throw the dice here.
The dice?
Here. I said dice.
You said dryce. Throw the dryce. Go ahead.
I'm going to throw it thrice.
Twice it is. First
thrice
one doesn't count.
Means three.
Oh, thrice.
All right. All right. So we're going to throw the dice. This is our trivia game. We're going to play that. Here we go.
Oh, right on top of the painting. Okay, that one doesn't count because that was one. You're going to do it three times.
Four.
That doesn't count. Oh, four it is. Number four.
Is. He's going to get a question. Anyway, saffron. Did anybody comment on what saffron was?
Stems of a fall crocus.
All right. It is this...
It tastes gross.
Yeah. Okay. So it's from the crocus flower. It's the little powdery stuff that comes off the stamen of the crocus flower. Okay? It's that little
powder. So somebody has to sit there with a paintbrush probably and get it off, right?
No. What they do is it can only... It only... It's from the crocus flower, which says that, you know, and it's a bulb, and it only blooms... one day a year, and you have to pick it before noon, and you have to sit there with the stamen and tap it like this with your finger like this onto a little piece of paper to get the yellow pollen off, the little powdery stuff off, right? Now, and that's the spice, and they have plant fields of it. They used to have everybody, all the neighbors would help. You'd stagger the crop so that you'd, because it's really labor intensive, and it's only good till noon. That's why. So it says it costs as much today as it did 1,000 years ago. Do you think that's interesting? That's not changed in the price. Saffron. They used to use that to make a yellow also. So anyway, history of the color palette and where yellow came from. All right. So I'm kind of doing this. What's our question, John, for our trivia question?
It's going to be a where question.
A where? Okay. All right. Get ready for our question, you guys.
Ah, here we go. We've had this guy before, so you should know this answer.
Well, you can't use the same question. Get a
it's no, one. We've had the guy.
Oh, okay.
Who I'm about to say, the artist.
Oh, okay. Well, that's a hint then, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. Edgar Degas traveled to the United States. True or false?
All right, you guys. Everybody.
And for a bonus, give me the year and where he went. Oh, yeah.
Well, that can't be a bonus if you told him. Now everybody knows he must have gone because he went somewhere.
No, I didn't say where.
Well, he traveled.
He traveled somewhere.
Okay, did he travel to the United States, true or false? And if he did, where did he go?
If he did, where did he go?
All right, do you notice that I'm putting in the lighter
one false, true, false.
Colors now?
We have a mix going on this one right now.
Okay.
Frisky Christy can't make up her mind. She did a true and a false.
Okay, so all right, we got a true
She's
and a false
confused.
There. She's confused. A little confused
true,
here.
True to New York. Wendy gave us New York.
Wendy said he went to New York, okay. Boy, I feel like I shouldn't answer this question, John, because I read his biography, and actually I'm copped out. I don't remember what it said. I have no idea.
Well, I've
got to
tell you
anywhere.
Right now, Alan's Art Adventures has nailed it.
Yeah?
Yep.
All right,
1872 to 1873, New Orleans.
Really?
Yep.
Wow, that is so cool, isn't it?
Did you remember that?
I didn't remember that. I just, like I say, we did his bio, but I don't remember that at
I don't
all.
Think I came up in his bio. Well, I did a quickie bio.
Okay, but honestly, gosh, I did not remember that. I'm using a little white.
So, once again, something's new has been learned for some of you.
Okay. Yeah, well, that's all right. I just, like I say, I didn't remember that. But that's not to say that, you know, you shouldn't.
Matter of fact, it was the fall of 1872 into the winter of 1873.
Oh, that's cool. That is a good one. Oh, that's a good one. I'll roll the dice one more time. That's a fun one. Tell them where you got the game, John.
I got the game on Amazon.com for
and what
10
game
bucks
is
or something.
That, John?
That game is 600 art questions to amuse your friends.
All right, so that's kind of what we thought we'd play where you're, you know, you're doing something like this. Just, you know, play that amuse your friends. That's kind of, you know, kind of fun to see where we're going with this. And
Alan's pretending to be smart.
Okay, so I'm going to put a little bit of yellow oxide and white now, a little burnt sienna. I want to come out the side here with an underpainting of some of this fur, like that.
Charity's made a comment. Man, you all are my people. Playing old people games and painting. Jeez, this is the life.
This is fun.
That's what we do, baby. Alan is a teacher. Hey, Alan, that's cheating. You're a teacher.
It's a cheater. Well, I think, I expect our teachers to know
they
stuff.
Better know.
Don't you?
Yeah,
they better
absolutely.
Know stuff. I mean, of course, that's not cheating. Nothing.
He went there to visit
that.
His family. Alan knows everything about this guy.
Well, you know, we did a nice history on him. If
yeah,
you haven't
did.
Seen
he
that,
he really has some nice
the
paintings.
Masters,
yeah.
You know, and we talked about what we can learn. I think our series is what you can learn from the masters. And incidentally, people have asked us to do more of that. John and I made an interesting discovery tonight. We made an interesting idea. We're going to continue that, but we're going to continue it on our, and continue the education, art education history, but we're going to continue it on gingercooklive.gallery for our subscribing members. That's where we're going to be doing it. Incidentally, good friends. That's what it will be, because we know a lot of people, you know, when you release four new paintings every week, every month, 4 to 5 new paintings every week, and you can't keep up with all of them, but I think that this will be an interesting, because we're going to take the masters, like we've already done Degas, but we're going to take the masters and talk about their artwork and what we as artists today can learn from them, okay? So you can see where we're just starting to bring these brush strokes around. You see what I'm doing? Starting to bring it around this way, and then we're kind of overlapping like this, coming up like that, and bring it around like this. Okay. Everything gets overlapped. Let's see if I can, I want to move this little pencil here.
Can you slip that reference photo over just for a half a second?
Tomato.
The reference tomato. Photo. The reference photo needs to be seen at this time if you could. That's the little guy that we
yeah,
got
now
it from.
This color here is glazed over white. This orange color here is glazed over white. So we have to come in pretty close to the eyes here in our layers and glaze that over white, okay? The same thing here. They said, you know, everything gets kind of put in layers like this.
And what's that color you're using? How did you make that little puppy?
How did I make this? This is just titanium white and yellow oxide and a little bit of Australian sienna.
The surprise color for the day. And if I don't have Australian sienna?
Well, then you could use azo gold from Golden, or you could just use a little burnt sienna, a little orange with it.
Okay.
You're just going into your gold tones like this, and see we're putting a little bit of this on our basket as well. Just a little bit on our basket weave as well. Okay, so I'm still coming over here like this. I want that. This is titanium here, and I want some very. We'll come back over the top of this with some more white, but we have to kind of dry it. And here's our first layer of stuff coming up here on his little face here. See, it's kind of they've got him trimmed where it's kind of short around the nose like that, and comes this way like that around the nose. And everything's being done with this little angle brush.
You know, I was just thinking of that.
This whole thing's being done with this marvelous little angle brush.
And that's a quarter inch or a 3/8 you're using?
That's a 3/8 inch angle brush. And every once in a while, you should rinse your brush. Here's why, because your paint's drying in your brush, too. It's not just drying here, it's drying in the brush. And you see how we're layering over everything? We're starting to get those little tufts of hair coming this way. And I want a little bit lighter right there. And I want to come up this way from this eye. And be very close this way.
Barbara's asking, can you use the unbleached titanium white?
Excuse me, what?
Barbara wants to know, can you use the unbleached titanium
white?
Yeah,
I think you could use unbleached titanium. And probably another one would be antique white would be a good one, too. You just want some light colors, you know?
Yeah.
So I think that absolutely, I think you could. You know, we're just saying there's some white right here like this. Okay.
Rhonda would like to know, do you have a doggy or a kitty?
I don't have either. I
she
used
has
to have
a bear.
Kitties. I have a teddy bear, and we have Sammy, who's not a teddy bear, of course. We have Sammy, and just ask John. He's, don't get started. John started on teddy bears, but we have Sammy. You know, when I was a kid, if you guys remember, those of you who remember, maybe from even in Europe too, you remember Stife used to have these giant zoo-sized stuffed animals in the department store, and rich parents would buy them for their kids. And I couldn't understand why no one was coming home with a giraffe for me. One of those giant giraffes, you know, I wanted those. And then the other one I wanted was the lion, you know, that you could sit on.
Yeah, that's big.
Just thought they were just the cutest things ever. Really wanted that so much. Now look, do you see how we're starting to pull our little animal together? See? And everything is layers with acrylics. You know, that's what I would tell you, is it's very important to have the layers. And very important to have the layers. And now we got to come back here and do a little shading on our, just with a little bit of burnt sienna and water on our our little basket here. Just cause a little shadow on the inside of each of these little heels coming down here like that. See, that makes a difference. Okay. And I want to make sure that I've got it light enough on the outside here in a couple places.
I don't see you spritz your paints. How do you keep them from drying, please?
Well, I can spritz them, you know. I mean, they're not really drying, though I have a fan behind me, but it doesn't hurt to spritz them. They seem to be hanging in there all right. One thing I do is I wet the brush. You guys, it's not always your paints. Wet your brush and wipe it off. You know, that's real important, all right? I can't tell you how important that is. All right, here's a little bit of burnt sienna, right? And I'm just going to come up here like this with that. Let's see, I think this is dry enough. Come over some of this with that color. If this is dry, it won't mix. It will glaze. All right, and you can glaze with water. We're just going to glaze with water above the eye here like this, over this like that. Okay, I'm going to do that here too, a little bit this way. We're going to come up and glaze over some of this because so much of this painting is layered. That's what I would tell you, is it's layered. And I want a little bit of burnt sienna and burnt umber. Okay. I want to come under this eye like this. I want it very dark. Let's put a little purple with that. I want it very dark. I'm going to come under this eye like this and come pull out this way. The same thing here. I want a little bit of dark right this way by the eye. Now that I've put that burnt sienna glaze, I can darken this eye just a little bit like that. And this is where my reference photo comes in very handy, because I get a little burnt sienna and cad red medium. And start doing some of these colors here like this. And I want a little bit of dark right next to this eye and bring it out like that. Okay, so starting to put the personality in. We want to make sure we've got some dark coming this way on the fur before we put anything else. A little bit more red, a little bit more reddish brown here. Okay, so see, can you see how we're starting to pull in together? Little bit of yellow and cad red medium now, or cad red light and cad yellow medium, right? A bright orange color. Again, we've got a glob, so we don't want that. I'm going to come up here a little bit with some lighter orange, like that, up here like this. This is our first layer of these colors. And even on our little nose on the left-hand side, okay, I'm going to put a little bit of this kind of glaze this orange color over the face. Can you kind of see how this is coming together a little bit? See? And you have to keep working the colors in.
Layering
the colors around. A little bit of burnt sienna.
There's a black and white kitty still on YouTube. It was not on YouTube. It's under our members area of gingercooklive.gallery.
I haven't put it up yet. Told you I didn't put this up yet.
No. The kitty. The kitty picture that you showed.
The kitty is on YouTube.
The black and white kitty is?
Oh, no. The other kitty. That one. Do you have a picture of that one?
The calico?
Yeah.
I don't know where it is offhand.
Okay. So, yeah. No, the black and white kitty is on our website. Okay. So here's this coming out here like this. A little bit darker under here. Like that. With the eye. We're just sort of emphasizing how dark we want it under this eye. Okay, like that. Bring some dark over the orange like this. Coming out this way. Starting to pull this color out a little bit. A little bit up here in the nose. A bit darker right there. And a little bit darker under here. And now let's kind of separate some of our basket weave with some dark color. And I think I want to pull this one in front of that one, so I'm going to change that. Say this one's coming this way over that one.
I'm not sure where this question's coming from. Nicole's asking, does Ginger use the wooden keys behind the canvas? Oh, those little plastic triangle thingies. that some canvases come with?
No, I don't. I don't use those at all. I don't use those at all. You know what I do is I spray the canvas with water and tighten it up. John will hand me a canvas, I'll show you what I'm talking about. Because if you're not doing this, you're kind of, you really need to do that. If you're not doing that. All right, so let's get a little bit of this orange coming up here like this. I think we're going to have to turn this white again and then glaze it, okay? Like that. And we're going to do a little bit more glazing up here like this. Okay? See? It's coming together, you guys. Can you kind of see it? Each dog's going to have its own personality. All right, so this one is good. Huh? All right, can you hear this? Can you hear it? Now, what happens is you take the water and you spray the back. You spritz the back of it. You can also spray it with a hairdryer, but you spritz it. This is real fabric, and it's cotton, and it shrinks. So, and this will tighten it up, and it'll help you. Besides sanding your canvas, it'll help you with the detail.
It's already getting tighter.
It's getting tighter. Now, as this water dries and shrinks, we'll just test this a little later, it'll even be more so. So that's what you want to do.
It'd be like a drunk.
Feel like a drunk here. Yeah, so
like
now...
Like a drunk. Yeah, just like a drunk.
Let me just get it. I'm looking at my picture here, I want to glaze this one back a bit. So I'm going to take a little bit of, a little bit of Dossening Purple and a little bit of water. Just a tiny bit of Dossening Purple and water. Let's see, what do we got going here? That'll work here. And then I'm just going to glaze this under here. I want this darkened a little bit under that eye there. Let's see, a little bit of, I don't want to paint it over, but I want it a little bit thinner. And then I'm going to just, I need to thin this down a bit. There, like that. Under this eye, I need to thin that down. Okay. So we're going to start working on the eyes again. All right, so this is our second layer on the eyes. We're going to take a little bit of white and phthalo blue. Want to come up here like this, and see here, got a little bit of blue on this, and a little bit of bright blue right on the top of the nose, a little bit of bright blue right there. And I want to make sure that I've got some, let's take, I love these little angle brushes because they allow you to do this.
A very teeny tiny line.
A little light area right here, and a little bit lighter right there on the eye. And then we're going to take a little tiny bit of white dot right there, okay?
Hey, Brenda would like to know, can you spray the back of a canvas even after you started painting it?
Sure.
Absolutely.
Yeah, you sure can. And, the other thing is I've traveled, to like Las Vegas for an art show, and sometimes my jacquelles got real loose, and I've sprayed the back with that. I was really afraid to do that for fear that it would, thin them out too much. Okay, but I've sprayed the back of those, too. Okay, so there's some, this is not, the left side is darker, so let's take a little bit of blue and purple and darken that up here. Okay, so let's see, what are we getting into? New rag time. New rag time. You can see how this is kind of coming together. It's kind of fun, don't you think? Okay, so here's the first painting I did this afternoon, see? So we're still working on it, but we're building up the layers. You see that? We're not done, but we can see how fast. This doesn't have to take a long time. It can be fun, be very whimsical. It's arty. We're not trying. It's very whimsical, arty painting that we're doing here. All right, so there's a little paper towel here. What is on the back of this? Some kind of color? All right, so you're going. All right, good. All right, now, here we go. And there's something there. All right, now, moving along on the eyes. I think we were at the eyes before I got distracted, weren't we?
I believe
you were. That's what I remember. Or no, we were on the nose here. So I'm starting to come underneath here and to thin that out a bit with a darker color. Here's the nose coming down here like this, okay? Bring that nose down. And I need to just straighten, kind of trim this one up here like that. Just a few little tweaks here on the eye. And then I'm going to take a little bit of Australian Sienna and water and kind of go over this part of the eye right here. Just kind of change that color there. That's pretty. All right, now you see it's starting to feel very arty. Now this has had a chance to dry. So let's take a little bit of burnt sienna and water and come a tiny bit of water, come up this way, make this a little darker like that. I'm going to darken it up here, and I want to darken this up here a bit. Above this eye, it's quite dark, right like this. Okay, and then down in here, it's going to go into our, we're either doing our lights or our dark colors in here. Do you see that? I'm going to come under here like this with some few little bits of fur going like this, under this eye like that. And the same thing here. We're going to come in front of this eye with some curly ones like that. And this is kind of coming up here like that, maybe going out like this. And then we've got a little tuft going this way. No, John had a dog that he left, you know, that he left with his kids in Michigan. And when his son has a dog, and his girlfriend looks very much like this dog. Didn't you think? We posted that on our Facebook page. Yeah. When I was a kid, I had a dog, a really neat dog named Lassie. It was a collie. My parents, my adopted mother's dog. And Lassie was just great. She was my childhood friend. Really liked that dog. It's true what they say about collies. They're definitely a kid's dog. Just that dog adored me, and I just adored this dog. I got to tell you, that really adored this dog. And all right, let's just bring something over here like that. And some little thin ones like this. And again, I'm going to glaze over this in a second. And then I want this a little lighter up here by the eyes. This is our next layer of light here up on here like that. A little bit of light coming over this way, coming out like that. Anyway, so Lassie lived, a long time. She's a great, great collie. She used to, wait for me and the cat after school on the school bus. And they'd wait for me. My cat would, too. It would meet me at the school bus, at the bus stop at the top of the hill when I got off from school. Well, I was the only kid in the family that gave me any attention. Everybody else said, yeah, we got a dog, and they'd get fed. But, kids will play with dogs for, they love it. They love dogs, and play with them. Okay, let's put a few little light hairs up in here now. All right, is this getting cute or what, you guys?
I have a question from the beach is me. I get the layering part, but how do you determine what color the first layer should be?
Well, you always start with the color underneath the color, which is dark.
In this case,
it's the darkest color. That's the background color. You have to work off something, So you see all these dark colors that are underneath all these light colors, and that's how you do it. It depends on, you've got to find the color underneath the color for each dog. It's going to be different. Where's our other dog that we've got? The one that's on our website. That's over on the hall, John. Show them that one. That one where we started with a completely different color for background. The one I mean. That's in the hallway.
Tell him about the Rottweiler?
The Rottweiler. Show him the Rottweiler. That is a cool dog. See, now I'm into white now. See, now I'm adding a little bit of white and just kind of pinching it off here. A little bit of white. I want to come this way, up this way, from the eye here, like this. Here's the white. See what we're doing? And the same thing here. Okay, rinse the brush again because it's picking up paint. Okay. John's going to get that. That's a cool dog that we painted there. And I'll tell you, it's a nice thing, learning how to paint animals. If you can get the expressions, and it doesn't have to be perfect. This is one of my favorite ones that we did. Check this dog out. This is our Rottweiler. And there's no black in this dog. But now notice the highlights are blue and purple. See that? That's a step-by-step lesson on gingercooklive.gallery. Again, I think this is a cool dog. But knowing how to paint dogs, conversely, the underpainting on this cat, look at this white cat, but what's the underpainting? Can you tell what the underpainting color is?
Ooh, it's silent.
No, all right, so there you go. So you have to think about those things, right, you guys? It's important to think about those things. All right, let's put a few more. Now we're getting into the more fine detail, coming up like this. Like this with the fur. You see how we're painting. See how we're painting him in. Here's a little yellow oxide. Australian sienna and white. And this is such a pretty gold color. Let me show you what that looks like when you paint that in. Such a nice gold color. Okay. Okay, I mean, that's really, and it's pretty bright. We'll tone that down a bit. Okay, and if we put a little tiny bit of cad red light with it, show you the difference there. If we do that, so like this, a little bit of cad red, and you see how that sort of tones it down too. But you see that sort of warm color? Now we've got some of this warm color coming off the eyes like this, and back under here like that. And we just keep adding the color. Then I'm going to change colors again. Maybe some cad red medium now, and a little bit of purple. Cad red medium and a little bit of purple. And there's this really neat dark red color that's coming up here on his eyes right here. See, right like this? See that? And the same thing here. This one right here like that, that dark red. Maybe off to this way, under here just a bit. Okay. Then out this way. Okay. I mean, you can just sit there. I mean, you can expand on these animals when you're painting them. It's a little bit darker under here. So I'll put a little bit more purple on the brush and just add some more fur going this way, kind of right next to our basket, okay? So I'm going to get a little basket stuff here. I'm going to roll the dice one more time, John.
Right on his face. A three.
Three. I'm rolling the dice.
That's going to be a win. Provided I pull from the right section, right?
Okay, what's our number three here? While we're rolling the dice, again, you see I keep layering the colors in, okay? So a little more gold in here, kind of separating some of this fur, layering it in here. Again, we're not drying anything with a hairdryer, so we're just sort of gauging where stuff is before I put it, right? And I think I need another one that's coming here. I'm going to redo one. I need another basket weave thing that's coming under here, coming up here like this. There, okay.
All right, here we go.
All right, we're ready.
This is a win. When did the Dada, D-A-D-A movement start? 1812, 1916, 2011.
When did the Dada movement start? Okay.
Do you know that answer?
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. You are so smart.
Not smart. I can make an educated guess, though. How's that? Okay.
And then, all right, and so your choices are 1812, 1916, or 2011.
Okay, go ahead and do your music, John. And then I want to, before you, yeah, all right. Go ahead and do the music. Da, 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 that's it.
Never heard of Dada. Me neither.
Dada music. Well, it's the...
I have two 1916s. I have three 1916s.
Let me give you a hint. It was part of the Impressionist movement.
I have four. Sometime in the last 200 years.
So now let's talk about when did Impressionism start? Let's talk about that.
Okay, let's talk about that.
When did Impressionism start? Well, you've got to think that Impressionism started when we got a paint tube. With the invention of the paint tube. Because guess what? Before the Civil War, which is 1865 in the United States, there were no paint tubes.
None.
Zero?
Zero. Huh.
So what did painters do? You can see some old movies about it. They mixed their paint in a mortar, pestle thing, whatever, however you ever pronounce that, and mixed the oil paint, and then they put it inside a pig's bladder. So it made like a balloon thing, and they
tied it.
They tied it off at the bottom real tight, so it was like a little bulb of paint, right?
So that made the tube.
No, it wasn't a tube; it was a ball.
Okay.
And then they would poke a needle in the top and squeeze it out and sew it up at night.
Be like a tube.
So it didn't go anywhere.
Right. So they made it like a tube.
They couldn't leave with it. They were stuck in the thing. But then there was this. The paint tube was invented for watercolor people around the Civil War. Okay, you get all this from this book, by the way, Victoria Finley, I want you to think. Don't I know that it seems very clever, but I just promise you, you get all this information from her, right? Oh, isn't this fun, you guys? Don't you think the dog's coming out cute?
I think it's adorable.
And so then they got the paint tube. Then they could go outside and haul all their junk and all their paint and permalion, their easels and all that stuff out into the landscape and start painting. And then they started seeing colors differently. Because before, this was when toneless and colorist started. Because before that time, everybody pretty much painted their pictures in black and white and grays and got all the values done, which is why they were able to get such a really good way to do it. Still not incorrect. And then they would glaze and glaze and glaze and glaze to get all those colors. All right, well, the Impressionists just took kind of gobs of wet paint, put it here and there, and made a picture, right? And people didn't like it. They thought it was junk. They just couldn't stand it. You know what I mean? That was a hard sell, boy.
So what's the answer there, Smarty?
So the answer has got to be in the 1914 or whatever that, 1914, whatever that 1900 was. What's my 1900 choice?
1916.
1916 has to be then.
It
is. It was an offshoot of the Impressionism.
So what is the Dada movement?
You know those little dots?
Oh, really?
I think so. Dada? I don't know. We have to look it up.
I thought that was pointillism.
That's pointillism. So it's, I don't know, but that's what it was. It's part of the Impressionist movement for sure. Okay.
Well, that's kind of cool. So, besides being educated and entertained, folks, come on, where else can you go?
All right. So yeah, we're great fun here. Now back me out a little bit, would you? Please.
I can. Here, let me do that.
Now zoom back out, and I'll put some more white paint out. I want you to just kind of see how we're getting our doggy. All right.
Let's get
I'm putting a little more white paint out so that I can just kind of see how we're getting there. Now, you see, now here's the first one. No two are going to be exactly the same.
No, when they're hand painted.
They're all going to have their own personalities, all right? But you can see how we're sort of, you know, layering this in here, doing some more light, bringing the brush strokes around, all right? Just sort of bringing it around. We haven't done any of the whiskers or anything yet. I'm still just working on lights and darks, all right? And again, here's my reference photo, which is really too bleached out, by the way. This is not a great photo in that how do you call that when it's been kind of overexposed with
overexposed.
The white of the dog? It's kind of been overexposed. And
yeah.
So, you know, we can get a little bit of white here, but you got to kind of watch it. It's more important to catch the movement on this than anything. That's what you really want to get is the movement. And the movement of the fur, the direction of the fur. This is, see how it's going, and this is going this way. Kind of like that. We've got some little short ones coming up here like this. And the more flopsy-mopsy he looks, the cuter he is, right? And these little short, some of the brush strokes are real short. Some are a little longer.
What was the name of that art book by Victoria or Vicky?
The History of the Color Palette. And I'll tell you what, writing probably, should I say something mean? I'm not trying to, you know, because not everybody's good at everything. She was a great researcher. It took, you know, I can read a book in a couple hours. John will tell you, I'm a fast reader. I struggled with this book. But it was so interesting, I kept going. Because, I mean, she went into the ochre wars in Australia, and which was interesting. And she got into the, the fights of over, green paint, frankly, was hard to come by. And Napoleon apparently died from the green dye in the wallpaper. And how people discovered varnishes and how that nobody wrote anything down. You know, if the French had a formula, man, they weren't telling the English, right? And if somebody died and he didn't have apprentices, what happened to that, okay? See, a little short here on the top. Oh, come on, isn't he getting cute, you guys? And so they weren't telling anybody. So at one point it got so bad in England where they didn't have a good formula for varnish, and they were varnishing paintings because you have to kind of preserve them, and the paintings were turning black. Ah, scandal.
Scandalous.
Scandal, because they said somebody had to do a book on some stuff to kind of preserve the knowledge, because it was just like chefs, you know, nobody wanted to share what they were doing. I mean, I have artists today that won't tell anybody how they do anything. I tell you how to do the stucco. I have to tell you how to do this. I'm not worried about you knowing how I paint a dog. It's okay if you know. All right? I'm going to make kind of a light orange color now and put a little color surprise on this animal here. Let's just put a little bit of bright orange color now.
I believe at one time you said you're doing a brain dump.
I'm doing a brain dump. And no two people have the same brush strokes. No people see color the same way. And all really I'm teaching you to do, just putting a little bright back here by the eyes, we're sort of boosting up the color a bit here. Kind of jazzing it up, okay? Kind of like you might do in a computer, kind of jazzing it up. And it gets cute that way, doesn't it? I mean, here's a little bit of bright color up here in this little ear, okay? And let's see, maybe this way we'll pull a little back from his nose up here like this, from his nose.
Carol has a question. How do you find the points on the eyes and the nose for the highlights if it's not apparent in the photo?
Oh, well, there's kind of rules for that. We have a whole thing on rules for that animal eyes. There's like rules for it, but generally speaking, I tell people to get a better, you know, it depends where the animal's looking at you, where it's going to be. It's not one place all the time, but generally
speaking.
And where
the light source is, too.
Yeah, then your light source is, but generally speaking, it's generally darker up here at the top of the eye. And it gets lighter toward the bottom. And now this photo doesn't show that, all right? It just doesn't show that at all, but it's true. And it's so a lot of times when you're doing eyes, for instance, it's a little lighter down here at the bottom than it is up at the top, all right? Just little that kind of stuff. There's little tricks you can do. But this photo, I thought, had a pretty good light source. In the eyes. I kind of liked it for that. And here's a little bit of a white highlight on the nose, right, like that. Okay, let's put the little highlight there. And then I'm going to just, I mean, you can see it's got some really good light sources on it. It had some very, very kind of phthalo blue and white, some very nice bright blue right in here like this. Let's make that even whiter. There you go. There you go. That very nice light color right there, and so you can kind of come back and sort of tweak the eyes a bit. Now, and it had a little bit of wash, like a glaze of phthalo blue right here over this type of the eye right there, like that. See, kind of tone that down, and this one too. It's a little bit darker back here on this one. You can glaze back over there, okay? A little bit, not quite so bright and in your face, and this one's a little bit darker. Here, I got this a little bit wide here, so I'm going to just shorten that up like that, okay? Kind of refine the nose a bit. And, you know, that's, you know, one of the things I can do. And let's see, let's get a little bit of orange here. I'm just sort of playing with the eye a bit like this. And pulling some kind of lighter, oranger colors up here like this around it, coming this way. The same thing here, kind of exaggerate some of this. Coming up from his eye over that now because it's dry. See, all these things, you know, can make a difference. And some of these under ones are a little bit, you know, darker. Okay, like that, kind of glaze over. And then he had, because I think I can use purple, just right here, he had these tiny little little whiskers doing this. You know, there were some, I don't know if you can see those, but there were a few of those. A few little dark things here, a little bit of dark stuff there. Dark right there in that corner. The corners were very dark here, so you want to make sure we don't lose that. These corners were very dark. It made the eyes seem nice and big and round. Okay? And coming up like this. So what you might want to do when you're done is go put a few of your darks back. I mean, we kind of chalked this in, so we might just put a few darks back on the top here. Kind of fix your picture up a little bit. And like, for instance, because you can see the edge of my picture, I'll do this. Pumpkin. Pumpkin. Okay, so I'm just going to paint the top of this a little bit so that you just, this is what you do with your leftover paint, you guys.
Go around your edges.
You go around your edges. Don't do it immediately. It's a waste a lot of paint. Use the stuff you're going to throw away anyway. Okay, so that helped it. Now you can see it's a little bit darker there. It kind of brings that in. I won't do the rest of that, but that's, you know, you could see that there. Okay, and okay, so I'm going to come around here like that. And so we've got a little, our basket weave. And I would say that we're doing very well with this. I want a little bit of white and orange. I want to come up here just a little bit, right here on the top of this eye. Right there. And just put a little bit of orange right there. Sometimes this is my kind of my last little things I'll do. Just figure out where I want to put something like that. A little bit of touch of orange. A little bit of fur coming over here. And then some white here. Let's get a little white coming off the nose here like this. Using just, don't you love this little brush? Just the corner of this. This is the next layer of white coming this way. Out from under here like this. A little short down here like that. And, okay, and then this. There, kind of wanted that little, I wanted that deliberate little piece of hair, okay? So we're painting kind of masses of hair in, we're not painting it all in. There, see, there's a little bit of white right there, and I think I got a little bit too much pink on the brush, so let me rinse it, okay? Take a little bit of yellow oxide and just sort of lighten that up, just a hair. Ooh, got some white water. Yeah, but, you know, buff titanium, that was a very good question. Buff titanium certainly worked with something like this. And let's see, we want to come this way and sweep some of this orange coming this way and then down like this. And then that way. Okay, so kind of over that eye like that a little bit. There we go, a little bit of orange right here. Wipe all the, I don't want any white on the brush when I'm doing this. So there, I'm constantly looking for new places to put color. There we go, right up there like that. Okay. And I would say that all in all, I think we could sign this one, John. I think he's kind of done. You get the idea of how you paint something like this. Here's our little photo, okay?
Here's your photo.
And
there's the final.
And there's our little final picture.
And, looks pretty good. Pretty doggone good to me.
To look cute to you? Okay.
Yeah.
And here we're, let me just move this out of the way. Here's our two together. And again, you're not going to, can you back me out a little bit, please? You're not going to see them, you know, they're not going to be perfect. You're going to see some will be a little bit different than another because you're going to paint it differently every time. I think in this one I had a little more orange right up here, which I kind of like when I put them side by side. I kind of like, I like the bright orange here, the cad red light. I light a little bit of that right here like this. Right like that, and a little bit of this bright orange color. Just dabs of it. You know, just a couple. You know, kind of give it a little pizzazz. Remember, artists, we already have a photograph. So what can you do to make this, you know, a little bit more interesting? Okay, but maybe just a little bit around there. You know, a little bit under here. Just don't go carried away with it, but I think, you know, a couple of bright things of orange can be very effective. And I think I want a little yellow oxide here off of this side. There you go. That off of this side on his nose coming out this way. And same thing here. I can darken up this side a little bit like that. Okay. So again, I guess, could you play with this for a little bit while longer? Yeah, you can, but you don't want to overdo it either. And if you have to, put a little of your dark back. You have to come back with your dark color. And if you got too carried away, just come back with a few dark pieces like that. You're right, my paint's kind of drying out, but you can come back with a little bit like this and just break it up a bit. If you got it too carried away or darken your corner like that. And here's your basket. Maybe we'll come down here like this. I think I had another thing that came this way on the basket, so maybe I can put that in here. This came this way and then kind of came down like that. And I could, you know, might play a little bit more with the bottom of the basket like that. But there you go. There's our basket. And this one came closer to that. There you go. So there's our basket. There's our doggy. Okay.
Sharon would like to know, would the red oxide work instead of the CAD red yellow mix?
Well, red oxide. You know, I don't think it's, I think there's a lot of just burnt umbers and reds in here. I think you could experiment and do a lot of different things. I don't think one has to be, I don't
that
own
precise.
Any of that, so I can't tell you. I don't own that color. You know, I got to tell you, I don't own it, but you could use other things. You know, when I look at this and I look at the paint, you know, the thing, photo, you know, maybe I want a little white, you know, just a couple little extra whites. But you got to be careful not to overdo it, all right? Don't overdo it. That's all I can say is don't overdo it. It's easy enough to just keep painting a little bit too much, okay? But we'll just stop right there. I think that's a good place. We're going to sign our name. Paul, I think you understand how you might go about painting something like this. And that's the key, you know? If we got that across, I'd say that was pretty good. Everybody got a couple secret words in today. We learned a little bit of art history. All right.
I think we did it all.
Hey, we did it all.
And
we had
you did
time.
It in under 2 hours.
Well, we did, didn't we? We kept it going here like that. We didn't do a lot of drawing, so we didn't show a lot of you know, paint. But I like our dog a lot. I think he's really cute. And gonna bring his nose down here just a little bit, make it a little longer. We lost him a little bit here, right, like that. Okay.
Sharon's asking, please tell me how long between coats of varnish.
Anywhere between an hour to the next day. No sooner than an hour, all right? Certainly no sooner than an hour, right? But you can, you know, you can do it, you know, it usually dries within an hour. But if you got 2 hours or a day, if you're not in a hurry, I would suggest waiting, you know, getting that. Let's see, how did I sign it the last time? This whisker seems a little bit wide to me. You know what? Here.
Now, as we're playing this game and we're giving double words, you still have to have one word from each of the lessons between now and the end of
March. No, they don't.
March. Yeah, they do.
They do? I thought they could have...
No, because people are going to want to start bringing them in because we already have 7 words out there.
Okay.
No, we have to have one word from each lesson. That's why we're giving two, because sometimes YouTube bleeps.
Okay.
Basically, we're forcing you to watch our lessons.
Don't tell them that. Don't tell them that.
Oh, that's a trade secret. Sammy! Put the cue card down, boy.
Don't tell them that, right? I just want to put my little whiskers back here. All right, sorry. Just had to put a whisker back. What did they do with that little brush I was signing with now?
Is that a whisker on the right? Someone asked that on the... Seems
what,
a
here?
Little dark.
Over here? Or here? Yeah, that was a little whisker right here.
That's a dark one.
Yeah,
must
I know, but he's got black whiskers. Look, he's got black whiskers. See?
Hell yeah.
See him?
Yeah.
That's where they are here. I just thought, the reason I put him in here is I thought they were a little dark. And part of me wanted to just put it in again because it seemed a little dark. See that? So even if I just fade it out a bit, that's a little better.
Yeah.
You know, don't you love acrylics? You just erase, you know? Oh, if I didn't want to do that, I'm just going to erase. And then there you go. You just do a little erasing. Here's a little bit of CAD red. Medium right up here like this. Let's try a little bit of yellow with it. Want a little bit of bright color. I'm going to get my color if I have to. Now, we didn't use any zinc white this time.
That's unusual, isn't it?
There, I'm going to get some bright red here if it kills me here. Because acrylics dry darker, and that was really bugging me, you know?
The secret words are not in the Raz episodes.
No, we don't put secret words in the Raz episodes. They're just fun. If you want to come, we're going to teach this. We're going to be doing it anyway. So if you want to come play, we're doing it and watch John learn to paint. You know what?
Come
I put
back
the
eventually.
Brush in here and now it's disappeared. The little tiny pointy brush. Didn't I have one?
You used to.
I had a little pointy brush. Well, we'll find it when we clean up. I still have to sign the name here. Where's that white paint here?
Well, we're assuming you can all hear us. Now, we're going to go ahead and close this puppy out because it looks like we're just spinning our wheels.
All I'm doing is signing my name. Gosh, this is never open.
I should probably clean that up like I did the other one.
Yeah, if you can fix that for me at some future date. That's never working right.
The release for this week is the cherries. We're sorry we didn't get a chance to show that to you.
Okay, well, are we back? Did you close this out yet?
Oh, I didn't close this out, but
well, let's just show it real quick. Maybe it'll come up. You don't know if it'll pin
I don't know what it's doing. I have no idea.
So we had the cherries right here. Let's show them. Didn't we have the cherries right here? Well, I had the cherries earlier. Where'd you put them?
I put them away from you because of the way you fling paint around.
Really?
Being safe.
Okay, so I've signed this like that. That's my name. All right, so here's this week's lesson, the cherries. For every week on GingerCookLive.gallery, if you're a member, you get a new lesson. This is the cherries that we're doing on a still life that goes with our apple and some of our other paintings, you guys. We're running a little behind.
We're shifting our schedule on the Thursday releases. So they're going to be Thursday, Friday, or Saturday.
Because we can't get all these things edited. We can't always get it edited, right, like that. So here we go. Just here's my little.
Well, it got up there for a second.
Okay, so you just got to forgive me because once I've got this little pointy brush, part of me wants to play a little bit here, like that. All right. Well, you could appreciate that, right?
I do appreciate that.
See, I mean, part of me wants to just this little pointy brush. Little, makes a very
that's
good.
That's a little fine hair. That brings it to full character.
Sometimes you can just put a couple little, little tiny. Everything's kind of dried up anyway, but sometimes you can want to do the whole thing or get carried away. Here's a little bit of a. There you go, like that, and blue, like that. There you go. I'm just doing a couple little small ones. Okay.
Perfect.
Oh, I think I think this is really cute. Don't you think this is cute?
I think it's adorable.
You know, we decided we like this picture. We were glad to share it with you. I think this will be a fun one for you guys to try to paint. Now, if you remember you go over to later today, go over to our Paint My Photo. And if you're wondering what that is, it's pmp-art.com. Okay.
Or if you do a Google search for Paint My Photo, you can find the URL, it'll find it. It's automatic searching nowadays. Come on, people.
Okay. All right. All right. I'm stopping. But this is so fun, isn't it? This is so fun.
It's a ball.
I'm stopping.
It's a brush. Wait. I see the brush going back into the paint.
I'm putting it down. You can back away from that. That's our picture. Hey, you guys, thanks for joining us. Likes and shares are important. Tell your friends about us. We appreciate that. There's a lot of YouTube chatter out here on YouTube. There's gamers and musicians and stuff like this, and these, you know, not everybody finds us, so share it with us, and friend me on Facebook, ginger.cook.92, and check us out at gingercooklive.gallery. Thank you.
Thanks, everyone.
Have a good night.
Night, all.
Good night, Sammy. Night, John.
Good night, Ginger.
Where's Sammy? Did Sammy say good night?
Sammy, are you still out there, buddy?
Where's Sammy? Say goodnight to Sammy.
Hey, goodnight, Sammy. Yeah, looking cool.
Are coming soon.
He's going to head back to the pool.
All right.
Night, all.
Night.